Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 48th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1223.
1-0. And liftoff. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Landing leg deploy.
Also on Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 49th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 11-9.
1. Ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 25th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
The following day on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 50th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1210.
1, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1094, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. A couple of days ago on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 51st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 675.
1, ignition. Engines full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Landing leg deploy.
Then, earlier today, SpaceX successfully launched their 52nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 684.
1, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a handful of Starlink launches. The first of these, the Starlink 693 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 6th at 1:48 a.m. UTC or tomorrow, Monday 5th at 9:48 p.m. EDT. Later in the day on Tuesday, we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 153 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 6th at 6:31 p.m. UTC or 2:31 p.m. EDT. A few days later, we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 691 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 9th at 7:54 a.m. UTC or 3:54 a.m. EDT. The following day, and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 154 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 10th at 1:38 a.m. UTC or Friday 9th at 9:38 p.m. EDT. SpaceX posted some information about the next Axiom crew and their planned launch date. It says the AX4 crew recently completed training in California ahead of their upcoming mission to the space station. Falcon 9 is targeted to launch Dragon's third human spaceflight of the year no earlier than May 29th from Florida. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the Pad B OLM as they look to roll it out soon. Work also continues on Pad B's orbital launch mount legs and gantry. Work on demolishing the high bay has been continuing. Interestingly, SpaceX appears to be in the process of demolishing a wall at Star Factory. SpaceX were looking to have more control over the Boca Chica beach, and an article was posted about it. It says, as SpaceX awaits the results of a critical election that would turn the location of its Starbase launch site into an incorporated Texas city, lawmakers have declined to give the aerospace company greater control over a main highway and public beach. As SpaceX looks to incorporate Starbase as an official city, there was a vote on it. Votes were overwhelmingly in favor of incorporating Starbase as a city. This post says Starbase votes in favor of incorporation. Out of a total of 177 ballots, yes 97.74%, no 2.26%. SpaceX posted a video and information about the Flight 9 Starship Ship 35 undergoing some testing. They said the Starship preparing for our ninth flight test completed a single engine static fire demonstrating an in-space burn. SpaceX also performed a six engine static fire test of Starship 35 recently. It ended in an interesting way with what looked to be an abnormal ending. After the issue with the static fire test, there was information posted about why this may have happened. It says during Ship 35 static fire, something on E5 vacuum engine exploded. The issue appears similar to what happened on Flight 8. At first, it looked like serious damage, but on closer inspection, it seems fixable. They'll hopefully resolve the core problem this time. Better to fail on ground than in flight. Flight 9 is not imminent. After the testing, Starship 35 was rolled back to the production site. Starship 36 was recently seen rolled out to Massey's test site for some testing. Ship 36 was also seen undergoing some cryogenic testing. After the testing, Ship 36 was rolled back to the production site. Starship 38's nose cone was recently seen moved out of Star Factory. Finishing up the video today, we'll take a look at the Cameron County website where SpaceX has a temporary closure. The temp closure is for tomorrow, Monday 5th to Tuesday 6th, or Tuesday 6th to Wednesday 7th. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia and Gage Telesz for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.